Hi everyone, I'm Marin, an engineer on the ClassKit team, and I'm excited to show you a new API we've added to ClassKit for file-based apps. Today, I'll go over Schoolwork and how it's used with ClassKit. Then, I'll do an in-depth review of the new API for file-based apps. Next, I'll walk you through a sample implementation. And finally, I'll show you how to test the new API using ClassKit's developer mode. Let me start by giving you a brief overview of Schoolwork. Schoolwork is an educational app that enables teachers to share assignments in which students use your apps to learn. When your app adopts the ClassKit framework and advertises assignable content known as CLS contexts, as well as starts reporting progress data on activities, teachers will be able to assign that content and view the progress data reported by your app. If your app is ClassKit enabled, teachers will be more likely to use your app in their curriculum. And coming soon, Schoolwork will be even easier to use and adds many new features to streamline teacher workflows, inform instruction, and provide data from your apps to teachers. Now that we're familiar with Schoolwork, let's see how the data from your app flows into Schoolwork. Your app submits data to the ClassKit framework. ClassKit surfaces that data to the Schoolwork app. The data is then presented to the student and teacher. Here is a view of Schoolwork with a few assignments of ClassKit-enabled apps. If we tap on one of the assignments, we can see an example of an app which has adopted ClassKit and reported student progress data. We'll go through the details of this use case a bit later. Now that we have reviewed Schoolwork, let's talk about our new file-based progress API. There are more than 190,000 education apps in the App Store. And while a lot of you have adopted ClassKit's context-based APIs, not all of you have. We received feedback specifically around apps that interact with files and how you wanted to adopt ClassKit, but context didn't quite fit your use case. Well, if you've been holding out on ClassKit adoption because your app is file-based, we added a new API just for you. This new API is for any app that interacts with files. If you have an app that can edit files or just open and view a file, then you'll love our new API for file-based apps. Adopting this new API enables reporting student progress data on the files used within your app when they are assigned in Schoolwork. When a teacher assigns content from a ClassKit-enabled app, they will be provided additional insights, which is a win for them and a great new use case for your app. One important thing to note is that your app must adopt Open in Place. When your app supports Open in Place, the exact file shared between the student and teacher will open in your app and not a copy. Here's the new API for adding progress data to a file. It's called Fetch Activity, and it lives on CLS Data Store. I have both the async and async alternative versions of this API shown here. You'll pass in the file URL of your file to this API, and it returns a CLS activity. Once you have the CLS activity, you can add progress data to it. Now, let's take a look at the types of progress data your app can submit. If you've already adopted ClassKit, then this will be a review of the current progress data types we have available. If you're new to ClassKit, these classes are currently being used on CLS contexts, but the same data types can also be applied to files. Here, we have a CLS activity. This is a class used to encapsulate all of the progress data associated with a particular file. We have a few types of data that can be added to a CLS activity. First, we have duration. This is the amount of time a student spent working on the assigned file. Time should be reported on all file types. To use this API, you simply call the start and stop methods that live on CLS activity. Next, we have progress. This is some value between 0 and 1. Progress is typically used when you can determine a student's progression through a file. For example, let's say you have an audio or a video file, and the student got 50% of the way through. You would report the playback progress as 0.5. To add progress, you can either set the progress property directly or add a range from some start to an end. You can add overlapping ranges or the same range multiple times. We'll handle the logic to make sure the correct progress is reported to students and teachers. We also have the primary activity item, which is useful if you have a file that can be edited. Setting the primary activity item indicates that this piece of data you want to highlight to students and teachers, and it shows up in the main part of the UI in the Schoolwork app. There's also an additional activity items property. This is an array of CLS activity items, which is useful for adding additional metadata. To add a primary activity item, set the primary activity item property on CLS activity. To add an additional activity item, call the add additional activity item function on CLS activity and pass in the activity item you want to add. The primary activity item and additional activity item properties hold a reference to one of our three subclasses of CLS activity item. You can add any of the following subclasses. First, we have CLS binary item. This is used to represent any binary data type. An example usage of this might be a question on a quiz. Let's say the student got it correct or incorrect. Or you can add CLS quantity item. This is used for any generic numerical value. You could use this for the number of pages, number of slides, or the total word count on a document. And the last is CLS score item. This class is used for anything that can be represented as a part out of a total. For example, a score on a quiz. The user got 8 out of 10. You can add any combination of these subclasses to an activity, one of them, or all of them. Now that we know the types of data that we can add, let's walk through a code sample of adopting this API into an app. Here, I have a sample app that can open and edit a text file. When the student opens the text file, I'll start the timer. The student will go through, edit the file. When the student is about to close the file, I'll record the total word count and stop the timer. Let's navigate to the part of my code that gets called when I open the file and the student starts interacting with it. I have an open file function. This is where I will start tracking time. In your app, you'll go to the part of the code that you already have for opening a file, and this is where you'll add a little bit of code to start the timer. First, I'll fetch the CLS activity for my file URL. Once I have the activity, I will call start to start tracking time. And then I will call save on CLS data store to commit the changes that I've made. Let's go ahead and add a breakpoint here that we'll come back to later when testing our implementation. Now, I also want to stop the timer when the student is done and add a primary activity item. So let's navigate to the part of my code that gets called when the student is about to close the file. Here, I'll call CLS data store shared fetch activity, grab the primary activity item to update it if it already exists, or create a new CLS quantity item if there wasn't already one. Once I have the CLS quantity item, I can update its value and set it as a primary activity item on my activity. I can add progress to my activity. And last, call stop to stop the timer. Then I make sure to call save. If we don't call save on CLS data store, then we will not persist any of the changes we just made. I'm going to add a breakpoint here as well. We'll use this to help us debug our submission of student progress data. Now that we've adopted the API into our sample app, let's see how we can test our implementation using Schoolwork and developer mode. First, we need to set the ClassKit environment entitlement to development. This is inside of Xcode. The default value is production. We'll change the value of the entitlement to development so that we can test using developer mode and Schoolwork. The next time we run our code, it will run in developer mode. It's important to make sure to set this back to production after you're done testing. Next, we need to turn on developer mode on our iPad. We'll open the Settings app, navigate to Developer, ClassKit API. We'll select Teacher to change our role to a teacher in Schoolwork. Now, we will open the Schoolwork app. When Schoolwork opens, we are presented with the teacher UI. And if we tap on the Create Assignment button in the top right-hand corner, we can create an assignment adding a file our app supports by tapping the Files button. Then we will select the file that we want to add, enter the class and the title of the assignment. You can also optionally add any instructional text if you'd like. And then tap the button in the top right-hand corner to publish this assignment to the class. Now that we've created the assignment, we can switch our role to act as a student and test our implementation of submitting progress data. So let's navigate back to the Settings app. In Settings, we'll select Developer, ClassKit API, and tap on Student. This has now changed my role in Schoolwork to act as a student. We'll go back to the Schoolwork app. I can see I am now logged in as a student because I no longer have the Create Assignment button in the top right-hand corner of my UI. In the middle of the screen, I see the assignment we just created. And if I tap on it, I'm shown the details of the assignment. I can tap on the file icon, and that will deep link me into my app where I start reporting progress data. The file opens up in my app, and my code gets called to start the timer. Here, we can see our breakpoint get hit after calling save to start the timer. And if we hit play and then go back to our app, I see the student progress banner drop down from the top, which is an indication that the save was successful and the timer was started. Then I'll go through, add a bunch of text to complete the essay. My sample app has a done button the student will tap when they are done editing the file. So I'll tap on the done button in the top left-hand corner. At this point, my close file function will get called. We can see our second breakpoint was hit for saving the word count as a primary activity item and stopping the timer. Then we can hit play and go back to Schoolwork. In Schoolwork, I can see the progress data submitted by my app. First, I see the time as 41 minutes. This validates that I'm calling start, stop, and save correctly. Next, I see the word count, which I set as the primary activity item. Any CLS activity item subclass I set as the primary activity item will show up here in the main part of the UI. The fact that I can see my word count as 558 words validates that my submission of CLS quantity item is working correctly. Now let's switch our role back to a teacher and see how the data submitted by my app appears to teachers. In the center of the screen, we see I have the average time and average word count for all students. Below that is a row for every student on the assignment. In the student cell, I see the data that one student submitted. And if I tap on that student cell, I can see the progress data reported by my app. We have the primary activity item, time, and one additional activity item, which is listed as readability grade level. And that is how you use developer mode to test your ClassKit integration. Don't forget to set the entitlement back to production. Well, great, we covered a lot today, from the new API to testing it with developer mode. Even if you don't consider your app for education, there's a good chance an educator does. And having it ClassKit enabled means your app will be ready for them to integrate right into their curriculum. So make sure to adopt our API. And thank you. Thank you for the feedback reports. And please submit any other feedback that you may have. We love hearing from you. And if you're interested in learning more about our context-based APIs, take a look at our previous sessions on what's new in ClassKit and our talk Introducing ClassKit from 2018. Thanks and have a great WWDC.